Before we get into the day, I am very excited that I have started a new series on my blog, and that series is called Maki Almari Se, where I will be deep diving into my mother's closet, my mother-in-law's closet, and things that are family heirlooms that have stories attached to them, that have a lot of history attached to them. So I will be bringing out all of those things from their cupboards, from the homes, and documenting those stories, just because I feel that I would want my children and grandchildren to know about their heritage, their lineage. I want them to know where they came from, and I want them to know their grandparents, their parents, and I want them to really feel the love that every time we buy things like sarees and bags, you always think that, oh yeah, I will enjoy it, but you know, my daughter will enjoy it too, maybe her children will enjoy it. I feel so good today wearing sarees, or wearing something that my mother purchased, or my mother's wearing saree, or something that my grandmother gave my mother. It just feels so special, and I want to leave that behind for my children. So the series, so if you haven't seen it yet, go and check it out on the blog. I will leave the link in the description box below as well. But so today it is, it's what, 9 a.m. and I have dropped the kids off to school. I have written in my gratitude journal. So my gratitude journal is also something I'm taking very seriously, because the year is coming to an end and I want to start off having changed a lot in my life. So, and now I want to work out, get the workout in, and then we have a lot of ek dori stuff that I want taken care of today. A lot of products to photograph, a lot of products to list on Shopify. So a lot of all that stuff to be done. So if you're interested in watching any of that, keep watching. So let's work out. And I'm glad I got it out of the way early in the morning, not very early, but nonetheless in the morning, and now I'm ready to take on the rest of the day. So let's go.
You better turn up, you better be there when I shake, watch me rocking if I can't stop. If I should fall, just go ahead, go and catch me, baby.
I'm all ready and I'm all set to shoot a few things today. Very excited because I am shooting this saree, which is going to go up on ek dori, and I have to take pictures for it. Very special saree for me. Let me tell you why. Because this has been hand embroidered, and some of it has been done by me and some of it has been done by Madhvi, who is a part of the ek dori team. So let me show you. So this is how the pallu goes, and on the pallu are these little hand embroidered roses and little flowers, and so these are the little rose buds that have been embroidered on the pallu, and I think it looks very cute on the pallu. And further down along the pallu, where is it? Yeah, here it is. So this is a very signature ek dori thing, which is a continuation of the doodle collection on the sarees. So we have some of this is scraps from some of our other dresses and things, and we have used all of it. We want to have zero waste or as minimum waste as possible. So some of those have been used here. The rosebuds are there again, and it says something that is very close to my heart. It says, you get in life what you have the courage to ask for. So this kind of hangs down like this. Then I am going to shoot another saree. Let me get that for you. The second saree I'm shooting is this beautiful white one with a blue ikat and temple border. I love this sari for its simplicity and just the colors, and I don't know, it just appeals to my heart. So these sarees, I was just reading in the book on sarees written by Rita Kapoor Chisti, and she was talking about sarees, and she said that earlier, when there were no chemical dyes, most sarees were in this white color. And then a wedding season, and before a wedding, the saree would just be sprinkled with a little bit of turmeric, because turmeric is considered very auspicious, and that would give it a slight bit of color. But otherwise, all sarees were pretty much this kora white color sarees, and it just, I don't know, it's just simple and beautiful, and I love it. So this is the second saree that I'm shooting, and this will also be going up on Ek Dori. So this was look one, the first saree that I photographed. You can see the necklace is also Ek Dori, and the saree, the pretty roses, and the doodle art on it, and this was the first saree that I shot. So this is look number two. It's the white saree. I love this saree, and I love the combination. It's a very fun gamcha blouse. It's really funky, I think. So this is the saree, and Maharani Bagh necklace. And let's go and do this. So this is the shoot location. It's just basically a white wall and a rug and me. That's it.
You better turn up. You better be there when I shake. Watch me rocking if I can't stop.
Okay, so it's 1:10, 1:15 ish, and I am done shooting the two sarees. Now, I think I did pretty well in terms of maintaining time. It looks like I have this on top of my head. It's actually a frame. So I think I did pretty well on time. Now that I have some more time, I also want to finish some jewelry pieces. Let me show you what I mean. These are a few jewelry pieces from Ek Dori. Now, this fabric that has been used to create the cord for the jewelry is not ordinary fabric. It is vintage fabric. It is really old. Actually, let me see if I can show you the fabric also. Hang on. Okay, so I'm back. So, this is the kind of fabric that I have used to create this. This is really old vintage fabric. This piece of fabric I have converted into a godari kind of thing. I want to use it in some of the dresses around the neck or something. So this I will use later separately, but this kind of fabric has been used to create these strings. This is entirely ready, and I wore it with the other saree. This is how it is. It has these layers, but the back still needs to be finished, and I was thinking about what the best way to finish the back is, and I think I'm just gonna stitch it and then wind it with thread and give it a very organic handmade kind of feel. I want to do everything by hand, so I'm gonna ask one of the girls to try finishing this off. I'm gonna show it to her, and so that'll be the jewelry. Now I am going to sit down and have my lunch. So this is lunch for today. There's chawal, dal. Dal is soul food for me. There is methi ki sabzi, and there is mixed sabzi. So this is my lunch, and then I will get back to work. I saw a little bit of MasterChef, and And now I have a lot of editing to do. So I will just be sitting over here and working on the computer. I am going to end this little vlog here, but not before showing you a couple of the pictures that we got. So this is one of the pictures from today's shoot. I really like this picture. What do you guys think? Do leave me a comment in the comment section below, and I will see you in the next vlog. So for now,